Hey everyone, it's Simply Bai and welcome back to my channel. So as the title stated, today I will be sharing with you guys my favorites as well as just a mini haul throughout this video. So if you guys would like to see more, please keep watching and we're gonna go ahead and get started. First thing first, I will go ahead and talk about my favorites. I don't have much, they're just pretty much beauty products. And this time it doesn't really consist of any like non-beauty products. So first thing first, I will just go ahead and start off with my hair products. And the first one is this is the only hair product I have, I think. But the first one, this one is the Thick and Full Biotin and Collagen Root Boost Spray. I truly love this. It really works on my hair. I got this after I purchased the shampoo and conditioner, and I just been in love with it ever since. This one really helps build up my hair texture, and it really does help with the thickening, which my hair is already thick enough, but I have noticed like a change after using this for 2 weeks. My hair did grow about an inch, which is not bad, but then at the same time it really helps penetrate my skin, my roots a little bit, so it really did help fulfill that. So I really like this root spray, and I got this for about like $6-$7 at Walmart. So if you guys want, you guys could definitely check it out. It's by far my favorite spray so far. And I really do like the fragrance as well. It smells, like I said, it smells like perfume, but it's not to the point where it's really strong. It just really helps with your hair. Especially if you do have dry hair like mine too. It really does help build up that shine as well. And overall, I just really like the spray. Moving on, as my favorites, I've been really into, doing like covering up my fine lines under my eyes. If you guys notice, I have used my Super Stay Concealer, which I've mentioned in thousands of my videos, but I recently just changed my concealer, and I went to the Instant Age Rewind, which I noticed a lot of people use this and they love this product, so I decided to try it out myself. This is the Eraser Dark Circles, and let me see. This is pretty much just the brightener illuminator, but I use this as a concealer, and it just really helps cover up my fine lines. I really don't have any dark circles, or I don't really have bags under my eyes, but I do have fine lines, and it does the job really well. I believe this is like my holy grail of this month, just because it really helps kind of define my under eyes a little bit, so it really gives that coverage. So I really like this overall, and it's by far my favorite. This was about $8, depending which drugstore you purchase it from. Walmart is always the cheapest place to get your drugstore beauty products, from my opinion. But overall, I just really like this. And then moving on, as you guys can see, I've noticed a lot of you guys wanted me to do more of a more dramatic, and I guess like a more smoky look on my eyes, and I decided to do one for you guys today. And let me know what you guys think of this look that I have on today. Just leave me a comment down below if you guys like it or not, or you know, don't dislike this video or something, let me know. So I decided to kind of just go with the smoky, dark, dramatic look today, which I'm not really good at performing eyeshadows. Like, I hate eyeshadows. I never liked eyeshadows. Even when I was younger, I just never liked eyeshadows. And but then, you know, as I've been like really, cause like I'm really interested in like makeup and stuff as well, but it's just not eyeshadow. Eyeshadow just not attractive to me. But I wanted to like really bring out my eyes. I wanted to try something different, by, you know, using eyeshadows. And like I said, I'm not good at it. So let me know what you guys think. I actually have been, you know, browsing around YouTube, just looking at how other gurus do their eyeshadows, and I'm just so in love with it now. The colors, everything is just amazing. And I decided to use this Sephora palette. And this is the one, I'm not sure what this one is called, but this is the, this was purchased a while back and just never really been touched. And it just have these really nice, beautiful, shimmery matte colors. And they just have a variety of colors in here, more like the neutral sort of, I don't really know what tones these are, but they're really nice, and they just have like mostly the smoky effect ones. And I just really like this palette, and I have these two colors right here, the shimmery glitter black one and then the gray one right here. I have these two on today, and as you can see, here is a closer look on my eyes. I do have it here, and I really like it. And yeah, so if you guys do have any requests on this look, please let me comment down below too. I'll be happy to do it for you guys. But yeah, this palette was, I don't remember the price of this, but it was bought, like I said, it was purchased a while back. But overall, I just really like this palette, and it's been my favorite for February, which I used a lot. And then also another thing I've been using a lot is my CoverGirl Nature Luxe mascara, which I received in my swap with Project AZ Runway. I've been obsessed with this, and I think I use this more than my every other mascaras I own in my house. So yeah, I really like this, and I just really like it because it really gives me that natural look, and it's not too clumpy, or it's not to the point where it feels like it's so like dramatic. So that's what I like. Although I like the longer volume length to my lashes, but I also like where it kind of just defined my lashes a little bit. So I really like it, and it does give you a nice coverage as well. And then moving on, my two favorite brushes, this has been beyond my favorite. I probably purchased this 6 times already, and it is my e.l.f. powder brush, which looks just like this. This is my favorite of all time, and it's just pretty much a flat brush, and I use this mostly for all my foundations, powder to liquid foundations. And like I said, I just really love the e.l.f. mineral line. I love everything about it. The brushes is very soft, it's not harsh on your skin, and then at the same time, it's very inexpensive. This is, I think, only $3 for the brushes, and I do own a lot of e.l.f. brushes. I am planning to buy more e.l.f. products, which I probably will do a haul on, so look out for that as well. And then this is the brush that I received from my swap as well. This is the Soho crease brush. It looks just like this. I've used this today to do my outer corners of my palette from the eyeshadow palette that I just talked about, which is this one right here. And I just pretty much took this crease brush and dipped into this color, black color, shimmer color right here, and I just kind of defined the ends of my outer corner eyes. So that's what I did with that. So by far, this is my favorite brush as well. It's really soft too, so I really like it. Moving on, also my Carmex has been my favorite. It's really moisturizing. I use this for my lips all the time. Lately I haven't really been too obsessed with wearing lipsticks. I just haven't really been in the mood to wear lipsticks lately, and I've just been sticking to either chapsticks or Carmex, and this has been a really good, helpful moisturizing lip balm ever for my lips. So I really like this. It's been my favorite as well. And then what else? So I guess these will be my next favorites. These are recently, like, as you guys could know, I'm really obsessed with the Arm Candy bracelets that my sister made, which I have two on right now. They are the black ones with the gold chains and stuff. My sister recently just made me some pastel colors for the upcoming spring, and I'm super obsessed with these, and I'm so happy that I got these. But these are the color bracelets that I just recently received. I got, she made me like this very nice seafoam color, which matched my pants. I will show you guys in a second. And then I also have like these other nice pastel colors, which I truly love, yellow and mint colors. And then she also made me a hot pink one, and then another gray one, which I've been asking for because I really like it. I am supposed to be choosing the winners for my giveaway for the bracelets, which I haven't come across yet, so I do apologize about that. I will put that up as soon as possible. I've just been so busy, so barricaded in like all my work, I just really haven't gotten the chance to put it up. So I apologize. I hope you guys don't mind. Don't bite me off, or just don't hate me or something. I will put it up as soon as possible. And if you guys do want any of the colors, if you guys are the winners and you guys do want any of the colors that I have right here, please do let me know down below if you guys want to change it. I can have my sister quickly do it for you guys, so I could ship it off to you guys as well. If you guys are the winners too, it will be shipped into these little cute bags I have in here. So it'll be stored just like this, and it will be shipped to you guys in within a week or so once I announce the winner. Now moving on to my mini haul. Another thing I want to talk about is my Remington This is also one of my favorites for February. This is the Remington curling one that my boyfriend got me. I don't recall where he got this from, but I'll ask him and I'll link down the information down below for you guys if you guys want to purchase this of your own. I really like this so far. It's a really good curling wand, and I did do my hair today using this thing, and I didn't do much throughout my whole hair because because my hair is not that long yet and my hair is super thick, it makes my curls look really thick and it just don't look right. So I just decided to pin it up today, and then I did do just like, you know, my layers and kind of just use this for a test and stuff. But this has been my favorite curling wand of all time. It goes up to 465 degrees, but I just would recommend you guys to be super careful with this because it will melt away anything that's plastic. I just experienced that because it melted my sister's basket, which I truly apologize about that. Just don't tell her, but yeah, I'm just kidding. But yeah, be careful with this. This will melt your hair, I'm not going to lie to you. And the good thing is it comes with a glove too, so you guys should be safe with that. But this has been my favorite for February as well. I love this and I just can't stress it enough. I'm just obsessed with this. So yeah, now moving on to my mini haul. So first thing first, I will talk about my accessories. My boyfriend actually got these for me on Valentine's Day. As you guys know, he did come visit me on Valentine's Day. We went shopping together, and the first thing he got me was this very cute rose gold chain bracelet, which I've been wanting for a long time now. I actually saw this like on I believe Etsy and Shop Lately, but it was like about $12 to $15 just for a gold chain necklace, like a bracelet like this. So I decided, you know, I should just wait around and see if there's any other places. So one day I decided to stop in Forever 21 and I came across this bracelet, and I just been super obsessed with it. And you know, on that day I didn't buy it, so on the day that my boyfriend came, we decided to stop in Forever 21 and he finally bought this for me. So I was really thankful and I just love it overall. I was actually planning to get a Michael Kors watch too, so to match this bracelet. So I can't wait, and I haven't worn this once yet, but I just love the bracelet itself and it's just really nice. It was very inexpensive. It's only about like, I think $580 or something if I recall. So it's like around $6, which is better than paying 12 bucks for a gold chain bracelet. And then he also got me these very cute, it's like sapphire, it's like, I don't even know really the color, like a teal sort of turquoise color. I don't really know my colors, but it's really nice. He got me these earrings, and ever since I wore this, I've been receiving compliments from it, and I just love it. It's really huge. It looks really big on my ears, but this is how it looks like when I wear it, and then this is just how it looks like, and just really nice color. It has diamond around the edges, and overall, I just really like it, and yeah, it's really cute. He made a really good choice of pick in these earrings, and ever since then I've just been obsessed with these two. And then also for the Forever 21 haul, he got me these very cute ombre style jeans, which is really new in fashion now. I've been really obsessed also with ombre. I was actually thinking about doing my hair in the ombre style, but I think I might wait until my hair grows a little longer to do that. So he got me these very nice ombre texture seafoam jeans, and it looks just like this. I really like it. It's like a lighter white shade and then just kind of goes down and gives you a very nice seafoam minty color, which I love. And then of course when it gets to the leg part, it gets even darker. So I just really like this about the jeans. And I got this my boyfriend got it for $24.80, which is pretty expensive, but it's not bad for Forever 21 jeans. I actually really like Forever 21 jeans, although these are my very few purchases. I don't really buy pants or jeans from Forever 21. Usually I buy them for Wet Seal or sometimes Hollister. I have owned only one pair of Hollister jeans before, and I just didn't wear ever since then. I don't remember what I did with them actually, because I used to work at Abercrombie & Fitch and we had to wear their jeans and everything like that. I just don't remember where I put it. Maybe it's still somewhere in my drawer, I just don't know. But the last thing that he got me, which I've been really obsessed with Mickey and Minnie, and I don't know why, I've just been really into like the Disney characters, like the shirts or just things in general lately. And then he also got me this I Will Be Your Minnie shirt, which I truly love. I saw this within a glance and I just wanted it. And Yeah, it looks just like this. It's really cute and I just love it. I also love how like on the cowl neck, it also has these little rib kind of texture on it. I don't know if you guys could tell, but it's like all around the neckline and I just love it overall. And I cannot wait to wear this. Like, I'm actually saving this shirt for the spring so that I could pair it up with my denim jeans, which I have. And yep. This was for $14.80 and I just really like it, so that's that. Now that is all for my Forever 21 haul. Now these two also, these are my hair products, and this one is the Schwab Max Hold hairspray. My mom has been a big fan of Schwab and I've never tried Schwab before, so I decided to go ahead and purchase one myself because she does have one. And then these are very inexpensive as well. That's probably why I went ahead and just bought this anyways. This was about $3. I got this from Target, and overall I really like this hairspray. It doesn't give you any leave you any residues, and all that at the same time, it really, really, really tamed your curls. Which, like I said, I've used this today, and I spray this, and as you can see, my curls are still locked in, which is really good. I actually used this together today, so I really like these two together. It's a really good combination for your hair, and I really like this hairspray. And the good thing is, it's also unscented, so it's really good. So. I really like this hairspray. Another product I just recently purchased, or I told my sister to buy it for me, and then she bought me it's a 10 Miracle Leave-In product. I actually watched a review from Simply Gal, so thank you again for requesting this. She actually recommended this product, and I've been always wanting to try this product from the get-go ever since I knew about it, but it's just so expensive. It's like, for just this bottle, it was $18, and if you buy it at the salon, it was like $18 to $20. So I actually decided just to kind of give in because my hair texture was just not, it was just, my hair was just always the same length, and I wanted my hair to grow faster, and I needed more of the shine and the lift. So I decided to just go ahead and purchase this, and then I used this yesterday and I've seen the results. It's not to the point with like the quick results, but it's just like you could instantly see shine, and really does help control the frizz, two of the main thing that it does too. So it helps pretty much repair dry damaged hair, which I have. It also adds shines, which I need, and then it controls frizz and all that good stuff. I'm not gonna go too much in details about what 10 things it really does with this product, but I probably will do it once I do a hair product review for you guys or something, if you guys are interested. But this is amazing. Like I said, I can't wait to see if I really like this product or not. And the consistency is like, it smells really good, and it's just kind of like a shampoo consistency, but I don't know, but when you spray it, it's like a mist, so it's amazing. I like this product a lot. And then my favorite thing, this is kind of like a mix of my February favorites to, I guess, just my purchases. Yeah, so like I said, it was a little turnover right here, and these are my Mary Kay products. I am not affiliated with Mary Kay whatsoever, and I'm not getting paid for talking about the products, but this is my very first purchase from Mary Kay. My cousin and one of my good friend is actually beauty consultants of Mary Kay. So one day my cousin decided to do a little gathering at her house with the Mary Kay. It's kind of like a Mary Kay party, I guess that's what they call it. And so we went over there, and she was kind of like giving us these products to test out. One thing is that I already went through this whole process with my friend before I even went to my cousin, and at first I wasn't too skeptical about it because, like I said, I wasn't a big fan of purchasing high-end products just because either I broke out from it, or two, it just didn't work for me. That's why I wasn't a big fan of always trying to reach for the high-end products. And then I decided to just go ahead and give in, since this is my second time with Mary Kay. And I purchased the Time Wise products, and these are pretty much the anti-aging products. If you guys are in your 20s, I would I would recommend you guys to all try, go ahead and start with your anti-aging products, just because you don't want to wait until you're like in your 30s to start anti-aging products, just because, you know, like I said, when your collagen starts decreasing or it starts breaking down, that's when you're gonna start, you don't want, like my boyfriend said, it's not de-aging, is anti-aging. So that's when you guys want to start. I would recommend you guys to start when you guys are in your 20s or 18 or something. So anyways, about the products, like I said, I was really skeptical about Mary Kay. I was never a big fan of Mary Kay or Avon or anything like that. And then my cousin was like, you know, I've been using this for months and I actually see results. I really like it. So I decided to just go ahead and give in. And then I bought the whole set, which was for $90 plus shipping handling was like around like additional $3. So I only paid around like $96 or something. And then ever since then, I bought this about, like, let's say the beginning of the month of February, and then I've noticed a dramatic change. I actually, within like 3 days, the third day, I actually saw results, and my face got a lot brighter, my complexion looks a lot smoother, and not only, I remember having a pimple right on my temple, right in the middle of my temple, and then the next day, it diminished within like minutes. Like, it honestly, it was gone, and my whiteheads was actually, I don't know what happened, but it was a huge pimple with whiteheads in it. But after using this, it was completely gone. So I was pretty astonished by this product, and I don't know, like I said, ever since then I just been super obsessed. I use this morning and night time, like recommended. And then after that, there's two other products that comes with it. It comes with a 3-in-1 cleanser, then it comes with the age fighting moisturizer, and it also comes with your day solution with SPF of 35, and then you do also have the night solution, which is pretty much different from each. This one is more like a lotion consistency, and this one is the gel solution with microbeads. Now, if you use this at nighttime, you notice that there are all these little microbeads inside. What happens is that when you squeeze the gel out, the beads inside actually burst into their peptide bonds, and it gives you that jelly-like, and it's supposed to, like, it's already in leather inside the gel. So that's probably why you guys probably won't feel it if you guys use this. And like my cousin said, it really does, you really do see it. You just let it leather right into your skin, absorbed, and just leave it like that, and then the next day you see results. It's really good. And then of course this day solution is like it's like the same consistency as this one. It's just like a lotion like and actually, let me just do a quick swap for you guys, or swatch for you guys. So this is how the day solution looks like. And then of course the night solution is just a very clear liquid gel. It's just like that. So this is your night, and this is your day. And then for the age fighting moisturizer, same thing, just there we go. So this is very lightweight, and this is the age fighting moisturizer. So this is your second step, and then depending on what time of the day it is, either day or nighttime, of course you would just apply that. So it's listed, it's right on the bottles for you guys. So this is, has been my holy grail, my holy grail products of my skincare. I haven't used my Cetaphil or my other drugstore products. I haven't touched them in like the longest, ever since I've been using this, because the Mary Kay product line has really changed my face. It has really helped my skin improved a lot more than Cetaphil has. So I was really shocked by it, and like I said, I am planning on repurchasing them. Okay guys, so this is it for my Mary Kay anti-aging products. I also did purchase a Mary Kay liquid eyeliner that looks just like this. The packaging is really cute. The only thing that I didn't like about it was the fact that it was $18 just for this tiny bottle. But like I said, you know, it is worth the money, because one good thing about this liquid eyeliner is that I do have it on as well on today, just on my waterline. But one good thing about this is the fact that the brush is not too stiff, it's very sturdy, and then the fine point, it's like a fine point pen. Here's just a quick swatch for you guys. I really like it because it's not to the point where it will like smear off, you know, whenever you have it on, or on a sweaty day, it won't smear off. And as you can see, it looks just like this. It's very nice black. And when I try to take it off, it doesn't come off. Like, you will see just a little, but it doesn't come off. So you will need like water. You need like a really good makeup remover to remove that. So that's one good thing about this Mary Kay liner. So this is it for my Mary Kay products, and I think this is all for my favorites as well as my mini haul. I really hope you guys enjoy everything I've mentioned in this video. If you guys do have any requested videos or any questions you guys may have on the products I've mentioned in this video, leave me a comment down below and I will try to get to them as soon as possible. And not only I do want to again apologize about my giveaway, I haven't announced the winners yet and I will try to put them up as soon as possible. I truly apologize. I've just been so busy and I just realized when I showed you guys the bracelet that I had to announce the winner. So I will do that as soon as possible. And of course, like I said this at the end of my videos, like almost every one of them, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And second of all, I did make a Twitter, so if you guys haven't followed me on Twitter, please do. You guys have a great Thursday morning or evening day, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye guys.